Welcome to the next video on the How Do I series of Microsoft Dynamics. This video will be about how do I do full SQL tracing for Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. I'm Waldo, or Eric Wouters, and I'm creating this video in collaboration with Platan. At the end of this video, you will have had a glimpse on how to do SQL tracing for Microsoft Dynamics NAV. We will enable tracing in NAV, start tracing in the SQL profiler, look at what comes out, and start analyzing the data. And we'll do this in three easy steps. Let's first see how to enable SQL tracing for NAV. Now, in the video, how do I use a debugger in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2, I already showed you how to start the debugger. To start full SQL tracing, you have to be in the same window. So you also have to start the session list. So we open it by clicking debugger and debug session. This will open the session list for me. And here we have the start full SQL tracing. And that is actually the first step that you do, start the tracing. And here you can see that the SQL tracing has been started on this session, the session that I have opened here. Now the next step is to open the SQL profiler, because that is the tool that is going to do the tracing. We connect to the same SQL instance by just providing a new trace. And here we're going to trace two events. We need to select the SQL patch completed and the SP statement completed. So you're going to select these, go to all events, and we'll select the SP statement completed. So these are the two that we need.